on, Stewie. You know you can't leave the table until you finish your vegetables.
Well, then I shall sit here until one of us expires, and you've got a good 40 years on me, woman.
Sweetie, it's broccoli. It's good for you. Now open up for the airplane.
Never! Damn the broccoli, damn you, and damn the Wright brothers!
My, aren't we fussy tonight? Okay, no broccoli.
Very well then, Who the hell do you think you are?
Honey, it's not gonna go away just because you don't like it.
Well then, my goal becomes clear. The broccoli must die.
Mom, will you take me out to practice driving?
I'm teaching a piano lesson in half an hour. Maybe your father can take you.
Sorry, Meg. Daddy loves you, but Daddy also loves Star Trek. And in all fairness, Star Trek was here first.
Captain's log, stardate 8169.7. The Enterprise has just discovered a strange new planet in the Gamma Fallopia star system. Mr. Sulu, ahead warp 9.
For God's sake, Peter, you've been sitting in front of the TV since you got home from work. Why don't you spend some time with your family?
I will. I'm just going to do it during the commercials. And if that's wrong, well, then maybe I'm missing the point of having commercials.
Please, Dad, my road test is tomorrow and you haven't taught me anything.
Meg, you may want to find a better teacher than Peter.
What are you talking about? I'm a great driver.
Remember your trip to the Southwest?
Oh, geez, did I just hit that ostrich?
No.
Are you sure?
Yeah, he's fine. Keep going.
Meg, don't believe what they're saying. I always keep my eyes on the road. I don't miss a thing.
We now return to Star Trek.
Holy crap, Uhura's black? All right, Meg, now here's your first lesson. Now, you always want to be aware of other cars on the road. And if you ever catch eyes with a guy next to you at a red light, you gotta race him. Oh, this guy's asking for it.
But, Dad...
I don't make the rules, honey. Now, rev your engine twice.
Okay.
Go. Well, you forgot to flip him off, but other than that, nice job.
You're back already. That wasn't much of a lesson.
Well, I didn't want to overload her on her first time out, you know? Besides, Chips is about to start. So let's sit back and get lost in a world of California Highway Patrol fantasy.
What's the charge, officer?
Driving without my phone number. Or maybe I should arrest you for being too beautiful.
Phil Broccoli, Mother says you're very good for me. Well, I'm afraid I'm no good for you. The first rule of war is know thine enemy, and I know this. Cold kills broccoli. It's so simple. All I need to do is build a machine to control the global environment. Forecast for tomorrow. A few sprinkles of genius with a chance of doom.
This is taking forever. Come on, Meg, let's go. Fox is running one of those new reality shows at 8. Fast animals, slow children.
Come on, guys, wait up! Oh, dang, I got honey all over my legs.
Dad, we can't leave now. My entire life depends on getting my license. If I can't drive, I'll never have any boyfriends, I'll never get married, and then I'll have to adopt a kid like Rosie O'Donnell.
Meg, are you implying that Rosie O'Donnell can't drive?
I'm so nervous.
Oh, you're gonna do great. Remember everything I taught you.
All right, let's start by going down Main Street.
Okay.
What are you doing?
I'm driving. Duh.
No!
were you going to mark me down for not flipping him off?
Oh, God, my life is over. I am the biggest loser I know.
Oh, I know just how you feel, Pumpkin. I've had my share of disappointments, too.
It's a girl.
Can you check again? Look, honey, you just have to remember that life has its little ups and... Oh, geez, we're going to miss the beginning of my show. Hey, there it is.
Dad, watch out!
Meg, honey, are you okay?
Yeah, I think so.
The Quahog Cable Television Transmitter. Uh-oh.
Hey, you just knocked out cable TV for the whole town.
Oh, boy. Hey, look, there's Bigfoot.
Whoa. This isn't about me. This is about you.
Oh, well, at least that bought us some time. She did it.
What? Dad, you were the one driving.
I was teaching her to drive, and she lost control of the car. Come on, you guys. We all did stupid stuff when we were kids, right? I remember this one time I tried to sneak into an R-rated movie. Oh, come on. Give the kid a break, eh?
Why should we?
Well, she got her arm shot off in Vietnam.
Oh, yeah. What a senseless war.
I can't believe you just sold out your own daughter.
Oh, Meg, honey, I know what I did was wrong, and I know this isn't the first time I've embarrassed you.
And if you add the measure of the angles of a right triangle, the sum of...
Hey, Meg, you mind cleaning out the shower next time you shave your legs? It's like a carpet in there. I hate to see you so upset. Hey, I know. Let's play a little game called Taking the Fall for Daddy. If you win, I'll buy you a convertible when you get your license.
Really? Oh, Daddy, now I love you again.
You're going to make some Jewish guy a great wife.
Because of an accident today at the Quahog Cable Company, all television transmission will be out for an undetermined amount of time. Of course, no one can see this news program, so it doesn't really matter what we say. I'm the Lord Jesus Christ. Think I'll go get drunk and beat up some midgets. How about you, Diane?
Well, Tom, I just plain don't like black people.
You guys, we're still on Boston?
Excellent. The weather machine is nearly completed. What do you say to that, Broccoli?
Stop mocking me!
What's this? It appears the witless provider has finally brought me something of value. I can use that crude device to amplify my deadly signal. Victory shall yet be mine.
Guess what, Mom? Dad crashed the car into the city cable transmitter.
What?
Oh, it's okay. If I take the blame, he's going to buy me a convertible when I get my license.
Meg, it's not exactly taking the blame if you go around telling everyone.
Peter, you're bribing your daughter with a car?
Come on, Lois. Isn't bribe just another word for love? Look, you wanted me and Meg to bond, and that's what we're doing.
Dad, I was in a chat room on America Online, and Doomy22 told me some idiot knocked out the cable. We could be without TV for weeks.
Now, Chris, now let's not panic. We can manage just fine without TV.
Huh.
Well, what's that supposed to mean?
Face it, Peter, you're addicted to television. And you're not exactly Mr. Cold Turkey either. Remember that time you tried to give up candy?
I'll ask you one more time. Are you sure you didn't eat anything in my factory?
No.
I'm just asking.
What, are you calling me a liar?
No, I'm just saying.
Hey, shut up, Wonka. Yeah, well, that was different. I'll be fine.
Are you sure, honey?
Now, for God's sake, you guys. You think I'm some simp who can't live without TV? Come on, give me a break. All right, Mike, what's happening now?
Well, Sipowicz is trying to find out who stabbed the super.
Are you going to tell me what I want to know, or am I going to have to show you my ass?
I ain't saying nothing.
Get it, Mike. Without actually seeing his ass, this is just radio.
Well, class, we were scheduled to watch a PBS program on the mating rituals of the nude, large-breasted Weewaw tribe of New Guinea. Unfortunately, Megan Griffin ruined TV. So instead, we're having a surprise test.
Whoa, suddenly I was public enemy number one. It was time to tell the truth.
Wait! I didn't drive into the satellite dish.
Oh, then who did?
I was just a 15-year-old girl. But at that moment, I realized I had a whole lifetime to make new friends, but only one chance to get a new car. And I had to take it.
Okay, I did it.
Jeez, Brian, I don't know how much longer I can last. It's been a whole week since I've seen a TV show. I wonder what Scooby and the gang are up to right now.
We now return to the Scooby-Doo murder files.
Gee whiz, gang. Looks like the killer gutted the victim, strangled him with his own intestines, and then dumped the body in the river.
Jinkies, what a mystery.
You're right, Scoob. We're dealing with one sick son of a bitch.
Well, you just need to find something to fill the void that's left in your life. You know, Lois has her knitting, Chris has his video games, Meg's learning how to drive, and me? I like the sauce.
Hey, barkeep, whose leg do you have to hump to get a dry martini around here?
Can't live without TV. Must see TV.